I want to talk this morning about coming up higher. You know, God has given you your life. God has given you something on this earth to do. But sometimes things happen to us. Sometimes we mess up ourselves, or maybe we get involved with something that doesn't serve us well. But it's important that you and I still go after the calling on our life. It's important that we become all that God has called us to be. I was reading in Matthew chapter 25, a parable. Sometimes Jesus spoke in parables. What he did was he tried to give some examples about how the kingdom of God relates to each one of us. In one of these parables, it was called the parable of the talents. But really, what the story was about is about three individuals. To me, it almost seems like a competition, or it kind of seems like one did very well, or two did well, but one didn't do so well. What Jesus was trying to say in the parable is that there's a certain way that you are supposed to live your life. And that's kind of what I'm talking about. I want to help us this morning. How are you supposed to live your life? How are you supposed to have a successful week? Is there something available for you and I in order to have a successful week? You know, there is a right way to live and a wrong way. You know, there's a good way to live. And there's a way that gets us in trouble that doesn't serve us well. We're here today because we believe that God wants us to have a good life. God does not want you to have a bad life. God wants you to be successful. God wants you to find the desires of your hearts, the dreams. But let me read the scripture. Just one verse. We're not going to be that long. But the man who had received one bag, in other translations called talents, but the man who received the one bag went off. He dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. You know, I'm looking at the verse of the man that didn't do so well. You might say, well, why don't you center on the two that did very well and Jesus was pleased with them? Well, I'm looking at the one this morning that didn't do well, and maybe I'm doing that as a way of saying, this is what we should do. So in talking about coming up higher, in talking about staying productive, you see, I really believe as a believer, when you come to Christ, you take on a whole new set of purpose for your life. You see, what was inside of you has been tapped. And God wants you to live again, to dream again. This is the beginning of the new year. Some are resetting priorities. We're supposed to reset ourselves and kind of look out and what type of year are you supposed to have? Where are you supposed to be at the end of the year? We're going to just share a few thoughts of where I think this person went wrong. What happened was, one person in the parable, Jesus said, wow, he gave them five bags, five talents, and what they did is they produced five more. Another two, according to their ability, I'd probably be in the two category or less, but he produced two more. I hope I would be. But the other one was in the one camp. Here's what the person with one did. He came and it says that he went out. He dug a hole in the ground and he hid what he was given. So here's what I first of all want to say. God has given you your life. You have breath this morning. You've woken up. You have a week in front of you. What kind of week are you going to have? The same as last week? Hopefully better. But where are you going from here? Is there something you can do? You know, I truly believe you determine how far you're going to go. You made a choice today to get up and worship God. You made a choice to be in the house of God. I believe as a pastor and as the word of God, you made the right choice. As a matter of fact, Pastor Joel says this regularly. When you put God first, what you do is you're setting your course for God to open doors and to bless you. Now, let me say this. Does that mean that you won't have challenges? No, that doesn't mean it. But it means that you are in the sight of God. You are in the eye of God for Him to do some things in your life that cannot happen any other way. But I want to talk about where I think this man went wrong. And we're going to look at that and say, okay, I'm not going to do that this week. You see, I need to do a good week. You see, I need a good year. As a matter of fact, I'm believing for some things to open up this week or this year. I'm believing that God is going to do something special in my life. Is that you this morning? You're here because you need God to show Himself out in your life. You're here. You've turned yourself over to the Lord. And you say, God, I'm in it all the way. I need you to show yourself strong in my life. What we see here, I just picked out three things where I think this man probably went wrong. We're not here to dirt the man or to plow away. As a matter of fact, because you and I, we have these kind of weeks. We've lived this kind of life, but we don't want to live that way anymore. We want to live productive lives. We want to live good lives. We want to live wholesome lives. For we know if we do, we can fly higher. We can go farther. We could become the person that God has called us. So three things that I picked out. And I feel a little bad for sharing about the guy that went wrong, but think about this. Think about NASA for a moment. If they put a shuttle, and but say early in the early days, when those shuttles didn't make it, it blew up partway or something, it didn't work out. You know what they do? They go back to the drawing board and they try to figure out what went wrong. Not necessarily what went right, though I'm sure they do that too, but they try to diagnose what went wrong. Here's what we're trying to do. We're taking a look at this to see what went wrong last week. What went wrong at this time in my life? And how am I not going to repeat that again? Because I want open doors. I want favor and blessing of God. Time is too short. I got to take it and grab it while it's here. So, a few quick things. First of all, that I see, these are things that I picked out. But the man who had received one bag, they all received something, but only one of them didn't do nothing with it. So here's what I see. He says he went off. Now, I'm not trying to make a big deal out of it. So my first point, well, I'll give all three of them. He went off. That's one. He dug a hole. That's two. And number three, it says he hid. So let's just talk for a moment about he went off. He was given what he was given, and he says that he went off. You know, in one of the other ones, five, it says he went straight and put it to work. This one, to me, kind of puts a drag on it. It says he went off. The way I'm reading it is that he didn't have respect for what he was given. He kind of just went into his week. He wasn't deliberate about it. He wasn't planning on something working out. Let me just say this. If we are going to see God's favor and blessing in our life, we got to be deliberate. You were deliberate by being here or listening online. You're deliberate. You're making a conscious effort. Here's what I want to say. You got a week before you. Let's be deliberate. Let's see what God wants to do in our life. It says here that he went off. Maybe he was too casual about it. Maybe he was one that wasn't thinking long-term about it. Or maybe he was discouraged in his heart. Maybe he allowed the problems of yesterday and he was still weighed down with the problems of yesterday. Listen, God promised us a new day every day. When you wake up, you got to say no to yesterday, your faults, your mistakes, the things you did wrong. You got to brush yourself off. As a matter of fact, you need to do it the night before when you lay your head down. When you lay your head down, you need to say, God, forgive me for every mistake I made today. Lord, give me a good night's rest and let me wake up renewed and refreshed. As a matter of fact, Lord, send your angels to watch over me and everything that you have for my life. This person possibly went into his day and it says he went off cavalier, maybe discouraged, maybe not being deliberate and not looking for everything God has for him. Here's what I want to say. When you start this week, as you leave here, you got to go in and say, Lord, I've served you today. Lord, I worshiped you. I come and I've given you of myself. Lord, bless this week. I'm going to end this week because I'm believing Monday you have something great for me. As a matter of fact, I believe Tuesday there's going to be an open door. Come Wednesday, that hump day, no, you're going to do something bright in my life. Here's what I want to say. Go into your life. God's given it to you. You have one life to live. You're living it now. You're getting older and you got still a lot on the table. God wants to do things in your life, but you got to go into it seriously, prayerful. You got to have the fear of God in you that unless God blesses me, I'm not going to get there. If I don't have the favor and blessing of God in my week, I'm not going to make it. So this person, I'm just looking at this and trying to decide, what did this individual not do right? I'm trying to be like the NASA scientist, which I'm far from. What went wrong? Why didn't I have a good week last week? Or why did I get involved in that thing? Or why did I do that when I should have maybe have stayed away? Is there something that I contributed? I believe this. I believe that you possess your own destiny. Oh, I believe that God has paved the way for you. God's did it all. But now you got to make the decision how you are going to live your life. And how high you fly is up to you. How far you go is up to you. Of course, we need God at the helm at the center. But he says, he went off. To me, it could have been a little better description. The other one says they went out. Well, to me, that's forward thinking. That's thinking of success. He went out right away. The other two, this one went off. The second thing that I picked up, he dug a hole. Now, I don't know about you, but many times, sometimes I dig a hole for myself and it don't serve me well. What do you mean by that? Oh, the language I use, I dig a hole for myself for that day. How I conduct myself or what I did the night before, I'm digging a hole. We're not called to dig holes for ourselves. We're called to get out of the hole. We're called to live a successful life, to live on top of the mountain, for God to work in our life. What I see with this individual, instead of him being constructive in his life, he was tearing down his life. What are you doing throughout the week that is tearing you down? What are you doing that is not contributing to your success? We're talking this morning about going higher. We're talking about doing better. Everyone here wants to have a better week. We want to have a good week. We want to do better. We want to have a good, successful year. We want to become all that God has called us to be. We want to sail. We want to go farther. Well, we see that two people did, and we're looking at the one that didn't. Well, we're saying we don't want to be like that. So we're going to go out deliberately. We're going to go off, and we're not going to go off. We're going to go out, and we're going to be proactive in how we think. If we know something's going to get us in trouble, we're going to stay away from it. If we go out and we know there's something there, no, we're going to learn from last week, and we're not going to do it. Number two, digging a hole. We talked about that. We're going to go on a thing. But here's what I'm thinking. A lot of times the words we use, we dig a hole and we stay in the hole. Once you're in the hole, don't keep digging yourself deeper. Be smart enough to get out of it. Okay, I didn't go to church last week. I'm not going to keep digging myself in despair in a hole. No, I'm going to pick myself up and I'm going to keep marching. This week, I used to try to work out. I don't anymore like I should. As a matter of fact, it's been months, almost maybe a year or three quarters of a year. But this week, as I was sitting in my recliner, we live up in the apartment, and I'm looking at feeling my stomach, I'm getting upset at myself. Because all I'm doing is eating and then eating some more. And I'm thinking, why don't I exercise anymore? What's wrong with me? Well, whenever I exercise, I think of something else to do. Anybody could relate to that? And, I'll do that tomorrow. So here's what I thought. It was a Tuesday. And I said, I'm going to do this tomorrow. But you know what? I've been saying tomorrow for a whole year. So you know what? I just got mad at myself. And I just had a sandwich. How many of you like those sandwiches? You know, Sue, make me another sandwich. No. So I had a sandwich, and I know if I had a sandwich, there's no way I could work out. Because I like to work out when there's not a lot of full stomach. Because when I stretch out, I can't stretch down. My stomach's in the way. Some of you can't see it, but trust me, there's a stomach behind the sweater. And so I knew. But you know what? I just had a sandwich, had a little milk, and I said, no, I'm going to run now. And I've never done, you know, I wait. And you know what? I'm glad I did. So I ran Tuesday and Wednesday, or something like Wednesday or Thursday, one of those. Here's what I want to say. I got mad at myself. Can you get mad at yourself and get back in the game? I don't know what it is that is holding you back. Maybe you got to quit digging the hole. I knew that I was digging the hole worse and worse, and eventually, I don't know if I'll ever make, it'll be such a big hole, I don't know if I'll ever make myself out of it, get out of it. I'm not just talking about that, I'm talking about anything in my life. Because when I run, truthfully, it's a more of a prayer time for me. Sure, I break off some steam. Those around me are glad that I'm shooting off some steam in that way instead of at them. So I'm shooting off some steam, but what I'm doing is I'm praying more. I'm taking an hour and a half, and I'm going, trying to go deeper, and I'm trying to find God in a deeper way. What about you? What do you need to shake up because you know the hole is getting bigger in your life? You know that if you keep, I like what my brother said, financially, you got to say that you're going to dig yourself out of this hole. You got to say, no, I don't need to be a person of debt. You know what God has called his children? To be lenders and not borrowers. That's God. You see, in Christ, it's a whole new world. I'm not saying it's all perfect and it's roses everywhere. And I'm not saying that. But I'm saying in Christ, he's called you to a new level. He's called you to be the banker of your own life. And here's what. But sometimes we're in a hole. We say, I can't get out of this hole. I'm so far in debt. I might as well go more in debt. My brother was sharing testimony. I didn't know what he was going to share, but I like it. But he decided that he wanted to get out of that. Let's not keep digging a hole for ourselves, for we're not called to live that way. We're called to live above it. We're called to shine. The third thing that I see here, it says that he went off. We're going to be smart. How we conduct ourselves, we're going to be smart because we want a successful week. We're not going to dig a hole. If we get an argument, we're going to apologize. I need to practice that one. If we get involved, we're not going to keep it going. No, we're not going to dig the hole worse. We know that it's best to live above ground, to live right. The next thing, it says that he hid his master's money. So the third thing that I got, that's what it is, he hid. We're not called to hide what God has given us. Now, what do you mean by that? It's a third point that I see. The other people, they went out and did it. Now, listen, I didn't say be careless, and I didn't say be, you throw it and be thrown to the wind. No. The other people went out and used what God gave them. They developed it. They had five, they had two, and they multiplied it and came back with five more and two more. The other one hit it in the ground and nothing came of it. Here's what I want to say. Your life, God has given you breath today. You're called to be a master of this day. It's true. You're called to be successful in your day. Be nice to someone. That's having a successful day. Bless them in some way. Speak kindness. There, you could speak kindness or you could speak rude. You can lift someone's day. We're talking about letting your light shine. Here's what I want to say. In order for you to be one that has a successful week, a successful day, you can't hide what God has given you. Listen, God's given you something. You know, my dad used to tell me, because we come from a bakery family, we work 7 days a week. That's how I was raised. Since 2 years old, we were going to work before school, after school, we were in the bakery business. My brothers still are. But my dad would always say, you know, we're not the smartest people, but you don't got to always be the smartest. You got to use what you got. Here's what I want to say. Some people may have five talents and not even using those. But even if God has only given you so much, you could become successful because it keeps going and it keeps going. Before you know it, you got more than everyone around you. Here's what I want to say. Take what God has given you and run with it. Take what God has given you and break forth this week. Stomp on the devil. Be a person of creation. God is a person of creation. He created you. He created this world. Be a person that goes forth. Be a person that tackles things. Be a person that shines for God. I didn't say be arrogant. Like, I have been a few sometimes in my life. No, do it in humility. Do it in love. Do it in kindness. God will take you places that you never dreamed were possible. Here's what I want to say to you. Some things that I just picked up. I just picked out three. Maybe you'll see four or five. I just kind of, things that attracted me, what I thought this person may have done wrong, or may have precluded himself from having a successful week. Maybe some things that I get hung up on, and that's why I point them out, are some things that I deal with. But here's what I want to say. He hid what God has given me. Listen, in your life, you're going to have some opportunities to shy away, or you're going to have some opportunities to shine. Listen, we're living in a dark time. God is looking for some Josephs. God is looking for some people that will go for him. Here's what I want to say. I really believe that the people of God are called to be Josephs in a world that we're living in. What do you mean by that? Joseph was one that in a difficult time, God prepared him ahead of time. And God used him when it was a difficult time, and he was a blessing. Here's what I want to say. You know what your calling is? You're calling for God contributing to you. Joel's dad used to say, after I remember one of his sermons, put the word of God in you when you don't need it, because when you do need it, it'll be there. Here's what I want to say. Practice of being strong. Practice, and listen, the whole world could go to hell and you're going to shine. You're going to be successful because you're a child of God. God has called you to be a winner. God has called you to be one that shines. Listen, the world may have a destiny to going the opposite way, but God and his kingdom is always going to win. God and the kingdom of God is always going to be triumphant, and you're a part of it. You are the kingdom of God. You are his child. Let me tell you this, and I'm going to close. There is no devil in the world, in all eternity, that could stand against you. You're a winner. Put the devil under your feet this week and go out and allow the Lord to use you in Jesus' name. there's someone here in our closing, bow your head just for a moment, and would say, hey, I need God. Hey, I need Jesus. And I'm sorry for going a little over, but we're going to be dismissed in just a moment. And so thank you for enduring. But listen, are you here this morning and you would say, I need God? Are you here this morning and say, I need Jesus? If that's you, I'm just going to ask that you pray a prayer with me, a prayer that I pray on a regular basis. Oh, it's not the same wording, but it's the heart that matters. So I'm asking you to ask God to come in your life and to renew you. So repeat this after me if you're so inclined. Dear Jesus, I love you. I'm sorry for my mistakes. I'm sorry for hurting you. Please forgive me. In my confession today, I receive you and your forgiveness. Come into my life anew in Jesus' name. Amen. Now the covering of God is over you, my brother, my sister. The covering and the favor of God is over you. The covering and the favor of God is over you. You have good things ahead of you. It's going to be a successful week for you. Let's stand together for the benediction.